Long time no see, and welcome to a new episode of Tech Check. My name is Jonathan Paula, coming to you from my newly redecorated office. Still kind of enjoying paternity leave, but it's time to get back to work and review this bad boy. BenQ's Ex3501R ultra-wide 35-inch monitor. And boy, this thing is a beaut. Especially if you adjust the color profile setting to something a bit more contrasty and vibrant, because the default settings out of the box were a bit too gray and light for my liking. The monitor has 60 millimeters of adjustable height, which is around 2.5 inches, and 15 degrees of adjustable angle. While the monitor's curvature seems significant from the sides, it's barely noticeable when you're sitting in front of it, say 30 or 40 inches away, making for a seamless and slightly peripheral viewing experience. The monitor also utilizes BenQ's eye care technology, which limits blue light and eliminates flickering to reduce viewer fatigue from prolonged use. But let's dive into its specs and see what's under the hood. It boasts a screen resolution of 3440 by 1440 pixels, which is not quite as big as my dual 30-inch monitors, but it comes pretty damn close, and there's no bezel in the middle, which is a big win, especially for you gamers out there. Or if you're a cinephile like me and love watching anamorphic epics like Lord of the Rings or Ben-Hur, you can do away with those letterboxes and you can watch that thing full frame. It looks great. Unfortunately, only about 50% of movies are in that 21:9 aspect ratio, and literally zero TV shows or web content, meaning you're gonna be stuck with pillar bars on the side instead of letterboxes on the top and bottom. And all things considered, I'd prefer the latter. At least then you could put subtitles down there. But that preference is up to you. It's a personal complaint I have about the aspect ratio, not the monitor itself, which by and large does what it needs to, and it shows content in that ultra-wide aspect. That being said, there were a few gripes I had with it, unfortunately, and those all have to do with the sides. When you're sitting dead center, you can't actually see the edge pixels all the way on the sides. You lose about 3 or 4 pixels on either end, and if you lean over, then you could see it. It's a bit like an Edge Galaxy phone, and it seems like the sides are rounded a bit. What bugged me more is the invisible bezel on the 3501R. Yes, it looks like the screen goes all the way to the sides here. It actually doesn't. There's about 1/2 inch of black plastic. I don't want to say it's false advertising, but it is a bit disheartening to see like a plastic bezel and then like the inside screen bezel that's even deeper than that. Some of these minor complaints of mine aside, the big reasons I think you'd want to get this is if you prefer the simplicity and aesthetic of a single monitor over a multiple monitor setup, or if you're into gaming at all. It is truly fantastic for games that natively support these big aspect ratios. Fortnite looked dope. Plus, it does give you a slight tactical advantage because you're able to peer around corners about 20% further than most of your competitors. Did that help me get a Battle Royale victory? No, of course not. Third place is still my best outing. But hey, I've been trying to raise my newborn daughter for the past 2 months, so I've been busy. And while the EX3501R does boast a robust set of menu options, they're all hidden underneath the monitor, which is a bit hard to access, and I found myself misclicking a lot. If you can't get over that, you can configure a lot of great settings: color profile, temperature, picture-in-picture, etc. Most of the common things you'd find in monitors today. But wait, there's more. We also have BenQ's ScreenBar e-reading lamp, which you can attach, as the picture might suggest, to the top of the monitor using a counterweight powered by USB. 4 buttons along the top that can change the brightness or the color temperature. Anyway, it's a great nifty little add-on, especially if you do a lot of computing in the dark. You want to light up your keyboard, but nothing else. And what's nice is the light is angled in such a way that it doesn't actually cast too much light on the monitor itself, just like straight down and onto the keyboard. I think this is a great accessory for any monitor, whether it's a BenQ ultra-wide or not, and I would recommend picking it up as well. Not gonna do a full review on this because it is just a light, not a lot to talk about, but yeah, this one gets a thumbs up from me for sure. But as for our monitor itself, time to give it a score in 4 key categories. Usability: it's a monitor, green light, you plug it in, it works. I love the simplicity there. Features: you have the curved screen, the cover for the back of your cables, which cleans things up and organizes it nicely. The ultra wide aspect ratio, I think, is kind of its biggest feature. All green lights there, they're fantastic. Quality: because of the aforementioned edge pixel issue, I have to dock this to a yellow light. Otherwise, the colors, the actual vibrancy of the screen is all top notch. And lastly, value, and this is the big one. At only $900, this is an extremely affordable 35-inch ultra-wide monitor. Everything else in this category is usually $1,100 to $1,500. At 900, this thing is a steal. I think you're gonna be impressed with the quality. I know I certainly was. This is a great single monitor solution if you can't quite upgrade to two separate monitors. As always, if you'd like to pick up one for yourself, please click the affiliate link in the description below, which helps support the show. That will do it for this episode, but if you'd like to watch more of my reviews, click or tap the thumbnails on the left. My name is Jonathan Paula. Thanks for watching. I'll check you later.